So in today's video, we're going to take a look at questions involving how we find the nearest fraction to a specific value. So the method we're going to look at today, which is extremely useful on non-calculator papers, is to find equivalent fractions that share a common denominator, which then we can use to see which fraction is nearest our chosen value. So for this first question, we want to see which fraction is closer to 1, 5/6 or 6/5. So to do this, what we want to do is find an equivalent fraction for both fractions we've been given, which share a common denominator. So the way we do that is we're going to look at our denominators, which are 6 and 5, and we're going to look for the lowest common multiple. So if we go for our multiples of 6 and 5, the first number we come to, which is a multiple of both, would be 30. So I need an equivalent fraction for both of these, which is over 30. So to get these particular fractions, what have we done? Well, on the bottom of the first one, we have 6. So we must have done 6 multiplied by 5 to get 30. So to keep this fraction equivalent, because we've multiplied the denominator by 5, we're also going to do that to the numerator. So if we do 5 multiplied by 5, that's going to give us 25. So we have that 5/6 is equivalent to 25 over 30. And then for the other fraction, to get from 5 to 30, we must have multiplied by 6. So again, because we've done that to the denominator, we need to do that to the numerator as well. So if I multiply that 6 by 6, I end up with 36. So our equivalent fraction for 6/5 is 36 over 30. So now we want to see which fraction is closest to 1. And we're going to do the same here also. We're going to convert that into a fraction. So we want to keep the denominator the same, so we're going to have 30 on the bottom. Well, if that has to be equal to 1, that must mean that the numerator is 30. So we have 30 over 30, which is equivalent to 1. So now to see which fraction is closer to 1, we want to see which one is nearest to this 30 over 30. Well, we can see that this first fraction here is 5/30 away. And we can see here that this fraction is 6/30 away. So we know that this fraction here, the 25 over 30, is our nearest fraction to 1. So for our answer, we need to put the original fraction we were given. So the fraction which is closest to 1 would actually be 5/6. For this next question, again, we want to see which fraction is closest to 1. So we've got 7/6 and also 6/7. So we're going to find an equivalent fraction for both of these, which have a common denominator. Well, again, to do that, we're going to look for the lowest common multiple of 6 and 7. Which in this case would be 42. So to get from 6 to 42, we must have multiplied by 7, which means we're also going to do that to the top. So if we do 7 multiplied by 7, that's going to give us 49. And then for our second fraction, to get from 7 to 42, we must have multiplied by 6. So because I've done that to the bottom, I'm also going to do that to the top. So if I multiply that by 6, we'd have 6 multiplied by 6, which is 36. So I've got my two equivalent fractions to the ones above. Now we want to see which one is closer to 1. Well, because we're working with a common denominator of 42, that's going to go on the bottom. Well, 1 would be equivalent to 42 over 42. So now we want to see which one of our fractions is closer. Well, we can see this 49 over 42 is 7 away on the numerator. And this 36 over 42 is only 6 away on the numerator. So that means that this fraction here is going to be our closest fraction to 1. So then for our answer, we need to use the original fraction that we were given, which was 6/7. And for our last question, we want to figure out which fraction is closest to 1/2. And this time we've been given 3/10 and 5/7. So again, we want equivalent fractions which have a common denominator. So we look at the denominators and we want the lowest common multiple of 10 and 7. Well, that would actually be 70. So we need two equivalent fractions over 70 now. Well, to get from 10 to 70, we have to multiply by 7. So I'm going to do that to the top as well. 3 multiplied by 7 is going to give us 21. And then to get from 7 to 70, we have to multiply by 10. Which means we're going to do exactly the same to the top. So 5 multiplied by 10 would give us 50. So now we want to see which fraction is closest to 1/2. Well, we want to keep our denominator the same so we can compare them. So we're going to have 70 on the bottom. So our equivalent fraction here over 70 would just be 1/2 of 70 itself. So that would be 35 over 70. So again, we want to compare those numerators now to see which one is closest. So we can see this first fraction here, our numerator is 14 away, and our fraction on the right is 15 away on the numerator. So our equivalent fraction that's nearest to our 1/2 is 21 over 70. But for our final answer, again, we need to use the fraction that we were given in the question. So our nearest fraction to 1/2 would be 3/10. So well done if you followed along with those questions. And that's it for this video. If you want to check out any other videos on working with fractions, then I've left some links for them down in the description, and I've also put a card in the top corner. So feel free to check them out. I hope you found this video useful. If you did, please feel free to leave a like and consider subscribing. If there are any topics you'd like me to go through next, then please just let me know down in the comments, and I'll try to make some videos on those topics as soon as possible. So thank you very much for watching, and I'll see you in the next video.